Imagine this, your customers land on your store searching for that perfect combo deal. But that's where product bundles come into play. They're like the superhero of e-commerce. They're value-packed solutions that not only will delight your customers, but also boost your bottom line.
Superhero landing coming up.
So we want to talk about Shopify Bundles today. That is the new app made by Shopify that is absolutely free. And yeah, let's go ahead and get started. Now, before we dive into the app, what are product bundles and why do they work? So obviously they're when you bundle two different products. You combine two related products together and you give the customer a discounted price. You wanna think of it as the unlimited combo meal, right? You get the fries, the burger, and the drink all in one. These bundles work like a charm because they tap into our love for deals, our love for convenience, and getting more out of your money. So when a customer is presented with a bundle that complements what they already have in the cart or something that they've already been eyeing for,
I got my eye on you.
It's gonna be a win-win situation for both the customer and yourself. So let's go check out Shopify Bundles and see also a little bit more information about the app. So here we have Shopify Bundles on the App Store. So you can see it's free right now. It doesn't have great reviews. 2.4 starting off the gate. Not a good indication. I was actually going through some of these reviews and it's pretty clear that I think a lot of customers were expecting a little bit more from this app. So I will say just right off the bat, this is a very, very basic bundle app.
It's pretty basic, but should still work.
If you're used to using some other bundling apps out there, like Bundler or any of those other ones, then this is gonna be a huge, huge step down for you. Now, this is just as of right now, right? As of the recording of this video. So maybe get your hopes up a little bit that Shopify will make this better for you in the future. Now, as you can see here, like, I mean, this person wrote a lot of different things in here. Ability to carry descriptions, like we'll actually get into some of these things, but before we actually go ahead and install, I do want to talk about the fact that they have some requirements in order for you to be able to even install and use the app. Now, some of these requirements are, number one, your store must be using the online store sales channel, as other sales channels aren't supported yet. So if you have, you want to use product bundles on Facebook or TikTok or Amazon, whatever, they don't work. They only work for your online store. Number two, you must unpublish all Shopify scripts. Now, Shopify scripts are, I believe, more so of a Shopify Plus feature. Yeah, so it was Shopify scripts and then the script editor app. These were Shopify Plus merchants, available for Shopify Plus merchants only, but these apps basically made changes to the cart and checkout. So if for some reason you have some scripts in the cart and checkout of your store, bundles may not work correctly. Number three, if your store uses any customizations on the checkout.liquid file, and again, any sort of thing that interferes with the checkout, you're gonna have to get rid of those things. And also, bundles must not be using any of the following apps: Global E, Licensify, and Recharge Subscriptions. Yeah, I mean, Recharge Subscriptions is a pretty big app here in the App Store. And again, if you're using this app, then yeah, you're probably not wanting to use Shopify Bundles anyways. You definitely want to have something a little bit better. Now, they do say if you don't have any of these things and you're still facing some issues or difficulties, just make sure that you contact Shopify support to make sure that they can look into it a little bit further. Hey, before I continue, I do want to tell you about one of my favorite themes right now, and that is the Aurora theme by Get Site Control. It's one of those very flexible and feature-rich, which I just love. Things like countdown timer, hotspots, in-cart related products, in-cart banners, marquee scrolling text bars, video embedding, and shape and color swatches. Yeah, shapes and color swatches. Now, I will say this is probably one of the newest themes out there. So because they're new, they follow a lot of the newest recommendations by Shopify, and is absolutely mind blowing and really, really good. I implore you to go check it out. Now, let's go ahead and get this installed. We have it actually installed here for our Totally 90s Kid test store. And we've already completed a bundle. And let me tell you, man, the experience wasn't the best. So let's go ahead and create our second bundle so we can show you how this looks in the back end. Once we click on create bundle, you'll have to name that bundle. So I think for clothing stores, you will have to call these bundles something. So in my head, whenever I started this, I was like, oh yeah, complete the look, right? But then you're gonna have thousands of titles that say complete the look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that may not be the best title. I think the best title is going to be whatever combo you're using. So let's say if we have just a black t-shirt with maybe some shorts, maybe that could be a, I don't know, let's do just simple black tee bundle. So you have to come up with some kind of title, creative title, for these, and then you get to select the products. Now, something that I did right away was I went ahead and went crazy. I was like, I want the burger, the fries, the Coke, and I want Frosty. I'm actually combining here McDonald's and Wendy's, but I want everything combined here together. And I selected like four different things. And granted, four of these products have, you know, five different variants, two different options. So there's a lot of different things, right? In just selecting one single product. So if you go ahead and go crazy like that, you'll get this red notification here that says a bundle can't have more than 10 products. So limitation there, three bundle options, or 100 variants. So right now I have about 625 variants just within this four products. Going back to the notice that this is gonna be a very basic app. There are apps out there that will allow you to do this. It will allow you to bundle all these four products together, no problem. But the way that Shopify works and the way that they have this app, they don't allow you to do that. So let's go ahead and let's see if we remove this product. So that we removed it, we still have 25 extra variants. I guess it's just gonna have to be a two bundle product. There you go, t-shirt and shorts. All right, and then the good thing is like, at least we have all the variants for the sizes, right? So small, medium, large, extra large, 2X. They're all included right within here. Just any other quantity as an option. Okay, so you could actually do a quantity bundle instead of just pairing up two different products. So if you sell, for example, basic tees, you can actually do the quantity as sort of like that option for bundling instead. Let's go ahead and cancel that and remove that option. So we're just gonna make it a simple t-shirt and shorts, but I think they're both tees, distressed tee and distressed tee. So bear with me here. This is all just the products that I have here within the store. And then let's go ahead and click save and continue. Now, something that you probably noticed is that I didn't have an option to play around with prices or the discount or anything like that. So the weird thing about this is that once you create the bundle in the bundles app, then it takes you to your products. So as you can see, we've moved on from down here, we're here at bundles. Now we're looking at our products up here, and we have our simple black tee bundle. It's set as a draft. And then all we have in here is just basically, it looks like a regular product. Like I have my regular product added right within here. So bad thing about this is that, and I noticed this when I created my first bundle, was the fact that I have to come up with my own description. I can't just very quickly copy and paste the description that I have here on these products already. And I can't copy and paste the images that I have already here in this, in these products. So to add the actual picture to my bundle, I have to go into add files, go look for my picture and add it in here. So a little bit of a pain, right? In order to make this actually happen. Besides that, the pricing option was also maybe a little bit confusing. I was almost like, wait, where do I put the discount? Because again, if you're used to the discounts here on Shopify or showcasing a discounted product, it should be right here, right? It should be the price and then price compare at. But I think what you need to do right within here is just change the price right within here. So instead of $44, all this is doing is adding the two products together. So both smalls, so small from this one and then small from this one together, the price is 44. So let's make it 22, 22, 22. As you can see, this can be a little bit annoying, right? To change the pricing for every single product and every single, I guess, combination, right? That you will have here on your store. I think it's good, right, to some extent, that you're having the granular customization there. I'm gonna go ahead and just add a random image just so we can see how this will look with a random image. And then let's see if we can generate some random text, vintage. All right, so we changed the pricing a little bit. We added the image, we added the description. Again, not very intuitive. Let's go ahead and save that though. And then let's click on preview to see how that looks. Okay, so there you have it. We have our title, we have our image, we have our size selection for each of the products that are in this bundle. That's the cart button. So yeah, it's pretty straightforward, right? It looks like a regular product page right within here. Now let's go and activate this. Something that I didn't notice was if I change the pricing there, it didn't showcase it as a, like I'm saving anything, right? From this bundle. And if we click here, I just wanna make sure it didn't change the pricing of my original product, but it did change the pricing of the bundle. So that's good to know. But I guess if we want to showcase that you will be getting some sort of discount, you will still have to click edit and then still do the compare at price. So if we put here the original price, which is $44, click save on that. And then we go back over here. Okay, at least we can now see that you're saving some money by bundling these products. And that's really the purpose, right, of having a bundle is to make sure that you're offering some form of discount for your customers. So again, a little bit of a manual process. You don't have the opportunity to say, just discount 10% off, right, from this bundle. It's going to be a more of a manual process of adding the compare at price, adding the new pricing and making that happen here. Those were some of the actual reviews that I read. They said a lot of these things and a lot of the things that I'm kind of complaining about right now. So again, a very, very basic app. You may be wondering, okay, that's good. Now I know how to create my first bundle, how to create products, how to add images and pricing. Now, how do you go about picking your products? Now, I would say to craft perfect product bundles that convert, you gotta get into the mindset of your customers. You know, what product actually go together naturally? Look, I've seen this time and time again where I go to a product page and then they have some sort of bundle that has like three different products that are not related to each other or just very different. And they said like, oh, other customers have bought this together. And like, that's what it is, you know? At the end of the day, you really truly have to look at your analytics. What kind of bundles would make your customers' lives easier? So what I would recommend doing is starting with your best-selling products. Look at all your best-selling products, then consider what would be a complementary item that could be bundled to that product. So for example, if you're selling skincare products, which is probably a little bit easier than clothing, you can actually do the cleanser, the moisturizer, and maybe like a bonus face mask or something, all at a discounted price. So the key is to make this bundle irresistible so that they take that next step of like, I'm on the verge of buying just this one thing, but you're actually putting it all together for me and I get a little bit of a discount. That's going to be more enticing than just getting that one thing. For clothing stores, it may be closer to what we just did here, which is more of a complete the look bundle. So you, whether you're pairing the top and bottoms or the shoes and socks, etc., you want to make sure that you're doing something that makes sense and not just, I don't know, having some sunglasses and a $5,000 suit right next to each other, right? You want to make sure that you make things that make sense. And obviously you're going to, because if you're using Shopify bundles, then it's going to be a very manual process for you to create these bundles and make it happen that way. Now, lastly, I want to make sure that I tell you to experiment and optimize. So don't be afraid to experiment with different bundle combinations, with different pricing strategies. You can offer maybe seasonal bundles, limited time offers, or you could even try to collaborate with other brands and offer exclusive bundles, right? They have that new app, Shopify Collective, right? Where you can actually bring in products from other stores. You want to make sure that you monitor the performance of your bundles using analytics and customer feedback. And if you notice that certain bundles are performing really well, then consider them, making them more of a permanent fixture to your store. If you've never done bundles in the past, then I would think Shopify bundles is just a good way to kind of get your feet wet with bundles. It's a free way to do that as well. Obviously, there may be a couple things, a couple quirks with it that I would hope that Shopify does fix in the future. But again, in a world where customers are seeking value and convenience, I think bundles is just a great, great opportunity to do that. Now, Shopify bundles was one of the updates that Shopify just recently released. And if you're interested in looking at the whole plethora of things that we're really excited about, that we're probably making videos in the future about, go check out that video next, where you'll see a walkthrough of all the things that are coming.